Este es el día que hizo el Señor, cantemos todos con santo fervor. Cielos y tierra muy juntos están, porque el Señor ha venido aquí.
Cantan las flores y alegran los campos, bosques y prados alaban a Dios. Así nosotros cantamos alegre, este es el día que hizo el Señor.
Que sea bendito, bendito sea aquel que viene en el nombre de Dios. Que este mariachi resuene por él, y cada nota sea un canto de amor. Cantan las flores y alegran los campos, bosques y prados alaban a Dios. Así nosotros cantamos alegres en este día que hizo el Señor. Este es el día que hizo el Señor, cantemos todos con santo fervor. Cielos y tierra muy juntos están, porque el Señor ha venido aquí. Cielos y flores y alegran los campos, bosques y prados alaban a Dios. Así nosotros cantamos alegres en este día que hizo el Señor.
Microphone. I didn't turn it on.
Oh, yeah.
That helps. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the healthy energy of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. We thank God that we're here together, and we pray for all the people who can't be here for whatever reason. Many of our friends and loved ones are sick with the virus. Our own president and our own first lady are sick with the virus. So we pray for them, and we pray with them that they'll be healed. In this Mass, we remember these sweethearts in heaven. Robert Rodriguez, Roberto and Maria Garza, Servando Eloy Escobar, Juan Hernandez on the first anniversary of his death, Diana Montes Flores, Juan Lopez, Aurora Ureste, Hector Santiago Garza, Andy Guajardo, golly, the ninth anniversary of Andy's death already. Guadalupe Garza, and Jorge Calabas, all members of our family of faith who cheer us on from the mysterious other shore, await us on the other shore, and cheer us on through these crazy days and stress and strainful days, stressful and straining. And through it all, the Spirit works through the hopes and fears, and through the joys and the sorrows. The Spirit's at work, even if we don't perceive it, He's at work. It is you, Lord, who called us into being. You called us to be here now in this time and place. You gave us the beautiful gift of life through the life of mom and dad, grandma and grandpa. Señor, ten piedad. It is you, Lord, who teach us to take delight in your life force at work, in us and around us, in us and each other and in all the creatures and all of creation. You bless our hearts. Cristo, ten piedad. And it is you, Lord, to bring us to the fullness of life and the fullness of love with you at the great banquet of the family in heaven, where many of our loved ones are now smiling down on us. Señor, ten piedad. Today, you probably know that already, I'm sure, from last week we talked about it already. Today is the feast of the great Saint Francis, and around here it's a great feast. However, the Borlote will change this year because of the pandemic. We'll have a drive-by at 3 o'clock. So And most of the dogs kind of prefer that anyway. They like to sit in a car with the air conditioner on and cruise around. At least that's the way my dogs are. So we'll start at the little plaza up the hill here, and then we'll just drive down and we'll just stand out here and bless dogs until there's nobody there, and then that'll be it. It'll be nice. So we remember St. Francis today. These readings are not chosen for St. Francis Day, but they turn out pretty good for reflection on the great saint, the things he teaches us. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we pray for those who are ill. Send your healthy energy to them. Heal them. Comfort those who are heartbroken at the loss of their loved ones. Lots of our neighbors are heartbroken. We're all heartbroken. Give solace to those who are alone and afraid. And give strength to the doctors and nurses who care for the sick. And give that creative energy of your spirit to the doctors and nurses who are working on a vaccine. Help us. Help us to encourage each other in these trying times. In your great love and mercy, send us your spirit by way of our fear. John Wayne says that true courage is to be afraid, but to saddle up anyway. So send us the courage to saddle up anyway, even though we are afraid. Energize us. Eliminate this scourge so that we may come together to give you praise and to build up your kingdom through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's see, here's another. Also in this Mass, we remember Wenceslao Puente. I guess you're going to keep that chair there.
First reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on fertile hillside. He spaded it and cleared it of stones and planted the choicest of vines. Within it, he built a watchtower. He hewed out a wine press. Then he looked for the crop of grapes. But what it yielded was wild grapes. Now, inhabitants of Jerusalem and the people of Judea, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I had not done? Why, when I looked for the crop of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now, I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge, give it to grazing, break through its wall, and let it trample. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briar. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judea are his cherished plant. He looked for judgment, but see bloodshed. For justice, but hark the outcry. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. A vine from Egypt you transplanted. You drove away the nations and planted it. It put forth its foliage to the sea. It shoots as far as the river. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Why have you broken down its walls so that every passerby plucks its fruit? The boar from the forest lays its waste, and the beast of the field feed upon it. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see Take care of this vine and protect what right hand has planted. The Son of Man, whom yourself made strong. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life. We will call upon your name. O Lord, God of hosts, restore us. If your face shine upon us, then we shall be saved. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
Segunda lectura. Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los filipenses. Hermanos, no se inquieten por nada. Más bien presenten en toda ocasión sus peticiones a Dios, en la oración y en la súplica llenos de gratitud. Y que la paz de Dios, que sobrepase toda inteligencia, custodie sus corazones y sus pensamientos en Cristo Jesús. Por lo demás, hermanos, aprecien todo lo que es verdadero y noble, cuanto hay de justo y puro, todo lo que es amable y honoroso, todo lo que sea virtud y merezca elogio. Pongan por obra cuanto han aprendido y recibido de mí, todo lo que yo he dicho y me han visto hacer, y el Dios de la paz estará con ustedes. Esta es palabra de Dios. De pie, por favor.
Aleluya, aleluya, aleluya. Aleluya, aleluya.
Yo los he elegido del mundo, dice el Señor, para que vayan y den fruto, y su fruto permanezca.
Aleluya, aleluya, aleluya.
The Lord be with you. A reading to Matthew. And Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, took him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" And they answered him, "He will put those rich men to a wretched death and lease his vineyards to other tenants who will give him the produce at the proper time." And Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, but the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes'? And therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit. The Gospel of the Lord.
So you catch that's an important detail in the beginning there. He's talking to the chief priests and the elders. He's in the presence of the scribes and Pharisees. And of course, the scribes and Pharisees have this mean streak, but they think of it as righteous. Well, it's a righteousness, meanness, or a mean righteousness. And there may be some mysterious connection there. You get too self-righteous, it's going to make you mean. And mean people can be very self-righteous. I have to be mean because this is the way it's supposed to be. I have to do it this way. Well, he's trying to call them down off their high horse. And the story he tells, you can see right away, he's talking about himself. God calls you to know him, to love him, and serve him. He calls you to discover his goodness and his truth and his beauty in you and around you. He calls you to worship him, to be humble, to be reverent, to be kind, to be generous in his presence. He calls you. And you, he's telling you, are rejecting him. You're rejecting God. You reject the prophets. And he's going to send his only son to you, and you're going to reject him. The mean streak is going to take over. Now, some people would say it this way, but I think it's probably a little bit off to say Jesus comes to neutralize the mean streak that's in us. We've all got a mean streak, some more than other. We were talking about that last week. Well, no, not neutral. He doesn't neuter us. He doesn't neuter us. He gives us strength to recognize that it's there in us and in each other and to struggle with it. And as we struggle with it, it ennobles our souls. But by recognizing the mean streak, I know it's there. I struggle with it to overcome it. And I become more aware of who I am. You don't become who you are by giving in to your temptations. You become who you are by struggling with your temptations, overcoming. The light of the love of Christ illuminates the struggle and energizes the soul in the struggle. That's what he's talking to the scribes and Pharisees about. But you notice in this, it is mysterious and miserable. The goodness of Christ comes to them, and they're not impressed. In fact, the goodness of Christ aggravates them. They want to cling to their evil. He's threatening, he's criticizing, he's challenging their evil ways. And instead of saying, "Yes, Lord, you're right, I need to do better." No, I want to stay comfortable in evil. I don't want him bothering me. I want to stay evil. And this is a big one, the sincerity of Christ, the humility of Christ, the authenticity of Christ really ruffles their hypocritical feathers. And, we're hypocrites and we're proud of it. We're hypocrites and we love it. You know, we're proud to be evil. We're proud to be hypocritical. And Christ says, no, that you can't. In the end of the story, he said, these wretched men come to a wretched end. Why? Well, because they didn't choose life. They didn't choose love. They didn't choose goodness. They didn't choose sincerity, authenticity, and that the goodness, the truth, and then there he comes to show them, you are beautiful. You're called to be beautiful. God's beauty is in you, created. You're made in his image. That beauty needs to be respected. That beauty needs to be cultivated. Needs to be appreciated. Needs to be admired. Needs to be nourished. And so, well, we're rejecting that beauty because we're comfortable in our ugliness. We prefer ugliness. That's the story there. Well, that's the eternal story. It's about the scribes and Pharisees who he's preaching to there, but it's about us, that there's a mean streak in all of us, and he calls us to overcome it. To overcome it, you have to recognize that it's there, and to recognize that it's there does hurt, and because it's easier to be righteous. Say, self-righteous cruelty. The world is full of it, but he says that's not going to work. That's not going to give you life. That's not going to help you become who God created you to be. You give in to those kind of temptations. That's toxic. That's destructive of the work of the Spirit in your soul. You're a work of art in progress. And part of the work of art is that struggle. with the mean streak, the selfish streak, the disobedient streak, the belligerent streak, the hostile streak. So he's given them a lot of food for thought, which they're probably not going to pick up on. But that's a good example of what St. Francis tuned into. St. Francis was a humble son of God, in love with life, delighted by nature, delighted by, he could see God's love all around him. He could see God's love in the poorest people, the most messed up and miserable people, in the sunrise and the sunset, and in the animals, and in the dogs, and the cats, and all of that. He could see God's love, and he was delighted. He was joyful in the presence of God's love, but humble and reverent and full of wonder, full of gratitude in the presence of God. When Pope Francis chose Francis as his namesake, his patron saint and namesake, you know, when a new pope is elected, he takes the name of some saint before him. Could be another pope, but it could be that in this case he chose Francis. Well, Father Jim, who had been in Rome, said that's very significant. Especially there in Rome, they always had the sense that Francis was a pobrecito. He told me the word they used in Italian. I can't think, poveriello or something. Anyway, he was a pobrecito. He said that's something that the Pope, who represents the authority of Christ in the world, chooses this humble, poor little saint, this poor man who loved life in the simplest, humblest way. And Jim was saying that this means more than we realize. And we saw more and more signs that Pope Francis was saying the family of the church to be alive, to be healthy, to be happy, to reflect the light of Christ's love in the darkness of the world has to be humble. We have to come down off our high horse. Pretty much what Jesus is telling the Pharisees there in that gospel. Come down off your high horse. Come down off your high horse. Recognize that you got a mean streak. Be sorry for it, but struggle with it and overcome it with the grace of God. Knowing that you have it. You know, Jim was an alcoholic, and he said, that's one of the things you learn. You have this weakness. It doesn't go away, but as you struggle with it, you become a better man. Knowing that I have to struggle with a mean streak humbles me. You could say that it hurts me, because it does, but it helps me become more aware of my need for God's grace. A couple of things that I remember, it's funny how you remember things that just intensely, little bitty things. When they happened, you didn't think of them as anything spectacular or impressive. But then years later, and I'm talking about 50 years, this one little memory. I had this beautiful dog named Gunzel. Loving the animals teaches you to be kind and teaches you not to be cruel and hurts you when you are cruel. You remember, I always thought I told you last week, I didn't think I appreciated Gunzel enough. She's just a wonderful dog, just the most amazing dog. She adopted me in San Ysidro. I was going out to drive the bus in the morning. She saw me. She went with me. I tried to sneak off without her. She followed me like a guardian angel. She got on the bus with me. And I look in the big mirror that the bus driver has. She'd be sitting there like one of the kids, just smiling. From then on, she was my dog. She died when I was in Roma. Well, she's buried in Roma. But later, I thought, that dog was such a wonderful creature of God. I did love her and I did appreciate her, but I can remember times when I should have been kinder to her and I wasn't. And I remember this one time. I was a young teacher in San Ysidro. I had come home and I was home with mom and dad at the house there. And Gunzel did something she shouldn't have done or didn't do something she should have done. And I punished her. Not excessively, but I punished her. I guess I can't remember. I swatted her or something. I can remember this like I just heard it a while ago. Mama says, Oh, darling, don't be cruel to her. She's just a little old dog. Oh, darling, don't be cruel. Well, in a way, that's what Jesus is telling the scribes and Pharisees and telling us. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to the God who calls you. Don't be cruel to each other. Don't be cruel to the creatures. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Another little memory from maybe 20 years ago when I was first pastor here, I remember telling Father Sko, I could tell him stuff that I wouldn't tell anybody else, I can remember telling Father Scholl that there was this one character who was a good guy, but I found him very worrisome. I said, something about his attitude really bothers me. And I was griping about this other fellow to Father Scholl. I could do that with him. It wasn't really in confession, but it was like confession. But anyway, I said, that guy kind of drives me nuts. I don't know what is the deal with this guy? This stuff he says, the attitude he's got, the way he reacts. And Scholl said, take it easy on him. He's just a puppy. And it was to treat him like you would a puppy. He needs some attention. He needs to be cuddled or respected or patted on the head. He needs a little cariño. He's a puppy. He doesn't have it all figured out yet. He's kind of goofy like a puppy. Well, that was great. I never heard anybody say that to me before or since. Take it easy on him. Give him cut him some slack. Have mercy on him. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. He's just a puppy. He wants to be good. Well, that's the kind of the sense. Francis teaches that well in all of his life and all of it. And it is true, learning to love animals and respect animals and not to be cruel or being severely sorry that you were cruel to an animal, that ennobles your soul, that cultivates your relationship with the spirit of love. There was, in the 50s, there was this great song, and that was the title of the song. You have to be my age to remember it, or maybe... Let's see if anybody does remember it. I don't see anybody in here that has as much white hair as I do. That was the title of the song. Don't be cruel. Oh, darling. Darling wasn't part of it. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Not perfect. True. Yeah, maybe she did pee on the floor. She didn't do it. But it's a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Anybody remember that song? You'd have to be... I'm talking about, 65 years ago probably. Do you know who sang it? Elvis. Oh, that's good. So Maddie is a 20-year-old Aggie, and I said, have you ever heard of this song? And she said, no, I've never heard of that song. And I said, well, have you ever heard of Elvis? And she said, oh, yeah, I've heard of Elvis. Well, that can be our song today on St. Francis Day. Help us not just not to be cruel, but to be full of reverence and delight and tenderness as we look at God's presence in each other and in the animals and in the world around us. We thank Him for the gift of life, the gift of the life force, the gift of the love force coming to us through each other. He speaks to us through the animals if we're listening. He's telling us all kind of good things about life and about ourselves. So as we offer the bread and the wine, we offer our hearts, our desire not to be cruel, of course, but our desire to be full of life and love, to follow the example of St. Francis.
If you can't come around, at least please tell. Something I might have. And I forget my past. And hey, don't be cruel. Don't. don't be cruel. Ooh. New heart, it's true. Don't be cruel. Ooh. New heart.
That might make you feel a little bit young again, if you're old enough to remember it. Okay. So, I was cruel to Gunzel, and I was cruel to Mama, who was asking me not to be cruel, but I was learning the lesson at the time without knowing it. I'm learning it now. And then Skull kept me from being cruel to the guy I was griping about. I didn't take it out on him, so that's a gift, a blessing.
They lost the liturgy of the Saints' Prayer.
What's that?
They lost the liturgy of the Saints' Prayer.
They lost?
The liturgy of the Saints' Prayer.
Of the what?
Oh,
that's okay. We don't have to do the Litany of the Saints this time. That's okay. Yeah, that's what Nick was just telling me, that they didn't have the book up there, the prayer book for the Litany of the Saints. That's okay. We know all the saints are praying with us and for us as we gather at the table of the Lord. So let us pray, my brothers and sisters, that our hearts and our memories and our desire not to be cruel, and our desire to be amazed and grateful, to be tender and generous with this holy sacrifice, will be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Lord God, our Father, the light of your love illuminates our memories in all the moments of our lives. Hear the prayers and accept the gifts we offer as we remember our sick brothers and sisters. Restore them to health and turn our anxiety for them into joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now this is a Eucharistic prayer. They call it the canon of the Mass, that we hardly ever use, but I always use it on St. Francis Day. I think you'll like it. It's a little bit longer, but not real long. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father in heaven, it is right that we should give you thanks and glory. You are the one God, living and true. Through all eternity you live in unapproachable light. You are the source of life and goodness. You've created all things to fill your creatures with every blessing and to lead us all into the joyful... I'm getting all fogged up here. Lead us all into the joyful vision of your light. Countless hosts of angels stand before you to do your will. They look upon your splendor and they praise you night and day. United with them and in the name of every creature under heaven, we too praise your glory as we sing.
Santo, Santo, Santo.
Father, we acknowledge your greatness. All your actions show your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own likeness, and you set us over the whole world to serve you, our Creator, and to rule over all the other creatures. Even when we disobeyed you and lost your friendship, you never did abandon us to the power of death, but you helped us all to seek and find you. Again and again, you offer a covenant to us, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you so loved the world that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to save us. He was conceived through the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, a man like us in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, and to those in sorrow, joy. In fulfillment of your will, he gave himself up to death, but by rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life, and that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him. He sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as his first gift to those who believe, to complete his work on earth, and to bring us the fullness of life and grace. Father, may this Holy Spirit sanctify our offerings. Let them become the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord as we celebrate the great mystery which he left us as an everlasting covenant. He always loved those who were his own in the world. When the time came for him to be glorified by you as Heavenly Father, he showed the depth of his love. While they were at supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine. He gave you thanks, and giving the chalice to his friends, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Anunciamos tu muerte, Señor. Proclamamos tu resurrección.
We celebrate this memorial of our redemption. We remember Christ's death, his descent among the dead, his resurrection, and his ascension to your right hand. And looking forward to the work of his Spirit in our hearts, we offer you his body and blood, the acceptable sacrifice which brings salvation to the whole world. Lord, look upon this sacrifice which you've given to us, your family, the church. And by your Holy Spirit, gather all who share this one bread and one cup into the one body of Christ, a living sacrifice of praise. Lord, remember those for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Bishop, and all who care for our family. Remember those who take part in this offering, all of us here present, and all your sons and daughters, and all those who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember those who have died in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith is known to you alone. Father, in your mercy, grant also to us, your sons and daughters, to enter into our heavenly inheritance in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of Christ, Saint Joseph, her husband, the blessed apostles, Saint Francis, and all the saints. Then, in your kingdom, freed from the corruption of sin and death, we can sing your glory with every creature, through Christ our Lord, through whom you give us everything that is good. Por Cristo, con él y en él, a ti Dios Padre omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo honor y toda gloria por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén, amén.
United by the love of Christ and faithful to the mystery and the movement of the Spirit of His love in our hearts, in the different stresses and strains and the struggles of our hearts, faithful to His teaching as it has come to us from Mom and Dad and Grandma and Grandpa, and as we pass it on to our children and grandchildren, we pray together in those good words that come echoing down through the centuries to us in the family of the home and in the family of the church from the heart of Christ Himself.
Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga su reino, hágase su voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Hoy nuestro pan de cada día, perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación, líbranos del mal.
Deliver us, Lord, from that mean streak, from the forces of evil. Graciously grant us peace and a sense of that same sense of wonder and gratitude that St. Francis had in our days. Keep us free from the darkness and destruction of sin. Protect us from all cynicism, apathy, and cruelty as we continue the great quest, seeking in joyful hope the way, the truth, and the life of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Don't look at our sins, look at our hearts, wounded and worried and weary, but all the more sincere and faithful. Look at our faith, the faith of Mary and Joseph, the faith of the apostles, the faith of St. Francis, the faith of our family, your church, and grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen. Let us give each other a sign of peace.
Peace.
Cordero, Cordero. Tú que quitas el pecado del mundo. Ten piedad. Nosotros ten piedad, Cordero, Cordero. El pecado del mundo. I'm
Beautiful. This is Jesus Christ, the bread of our lives, the force, the love force of the Spirit of the risen Christ, nourishing our hearts and souls and minds and memories. Happy are we who are called to seek Him and to cooperate with that Spirit of His love. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Now I'll say the prayer after communion now, and then we'll go to communion at the end. I don't think I have any extra announcements. For the people who go to Mass with us on the live stream or the online, I'm glad to hear that you get something out of it. I know we've had a lot of technological problems. They said last week was poor old static. I don't know if it was a bad sermon or it was really what, but anyway, we're still working on it. We're getting more and more high-tech stuff to make it better. So I hope it'll, I guess it'll never be perfect because it'll be me saying Mass, but it'll get better. So let us pray. God our Father, you come to us, you reach out to us, you send us the Spirit of your love, not in spite of, but because of our struggles with our human weakness. We pray now that you show to our sick brothers and sisters the power of your loving care and your great kindness. Make them well and restore them to the family of the home and to the family of the church. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. God has called us through Christ out of the darkness into his wonderful light. May we experience his kindness and blessings and be strong and hearty in faith, in hope, and in love. Amen. Amen. Because we are on this amazing quest, seeking and following Christ, who appeared as a light stronger than all the darkness of sin and death, all the cruelty in the world, may he make us reflections of that light to all those we share this journey with. Amen. May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon our hearts and our lungs and remain with us forever. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us come to the table of the Lord to share and be nourished by the bread of life. Thanks be to God, and thanks to all of you. Have a beautiful day. We'll see you at the Blessing of the Animals.
Ready? Mm-hmm. I'm going to go. Ready?
Mm-hmm. Hazme un instrumento de paz, donde haya odio lleve yo tu amor, donde haya injuria tu perdón, Señor, donde haya duda de en ti, Maestro, ayúdame a nunca buscar el ser consolado, sino ser entendido, sino ser amado, sino yo amar. Hazme un instrumento de tu paz, que lleve tu esperanza por él. Donde haya oscuridad, lleve tu luz. Donde haya pena, tu gozo, Señor. Maestro, ayúdame a nunca buscar.
consolado, si no ser entendido, si no ser amado, si no yo amar. Hazme un instrumento de tu paz, perdonando que nos das perdón, es dando a todos como tú nos das, muriendo es que volvemos a nacer. Maestro, ayúdame a nunca buscar el ser consolado, sino consolar. Ser entendido, sino entender. Ser amado, sino yo amar. Hazme un instrumento de tu paz, donde haya odio lleve yo tu amor, donde haya injuria tu perdón, Señor, donde haya duda fe en ti. Maestro, ayúdame a nunca consolar, ser entendido sino entender, ser amado sino amar. Hazme un instrumento de tu paz, que lleve tu esperanza por doquier, donde haya oscuridad lleve tu luz, donde haya pena tu gozo, Señor. Maestro, ayuda el ser consolado, sino consolar, ser entendido, sino ser amado, sino yo amar. Hazme un instrumento de tu paz,